While more speculation has been raised on the reasons for NATO's intervention in Libya. And as RT's Laura Emmett reports, the organization may have been trying to prevent Gaddafi from burying the American buck.
According to some, it's about protecting civilians.
We must not tolerate this regime using military force against its own people.
Others say it's about oil.
The only reason they're interested with Libya is about the oil. You'd think we'd be in Iraq if the major export there was broccoli.
But some are convinced intervention in Libya is all about currency, specifically Gaddafi's plan to introduce the gold dinar, a single African currency made from gold, a true sharing of the wealth.
It's one of these things that you have to plan almost in secret, because as soon as you say you're going to change over from the dollar to the something else, you're going to be targeted. There were two conferences on this, one in 96 and another one in the year 2000, called the World Mataba Conference, organized by Gaddafi. And everybody was interested. I think most countries in Africa were keen.
Gaddafi didn't give up. In the months leading up to the military intervention, he called on African and Muslim nations to join together to create this new currency that would rival the dollar and euro. They would sell oil and other resources around the world only for gold dinars. It's an idea that would shift the economic balance of the world. Countries' wealth would depend on how much gold they have, not how many dollars they trade. And Libya has 144 tons of gold. The UK has double that, but 10 times the population.
If Gaddafi had an intent to try to reprice his oil or whatever else the country was selling in the global markets and accept something else as a currency, or maybe launch a gold dinar currency, any move such as that would certainly not be welcomed by the power elite today, who are responsible for controlling the world's central banks. So yes, that would certainly be something that would cause his immediate dismissal and the need for other reasons to be brought forth for removing him from power.
It's happened before. In 2000, Saddam Hussein announced Iraqi oil would be traded in euros, not dollars. Sanctions and an invasion followed, some say because the Americans were desperate to prevent OPEC from transferring oil trading in all its member countries to the euro.
The UK's gold is kept here in a secure vault somewhere in the depths of the Bank of England. As in most developed countries, there's not enough to go around. But that's not the case in places like Libya and many of the Gulf states. A gold dinar would have given oil-rich African and Middle Eastern countries the power to turn around to their energy-hungry customers and say, sorry, the price has gone up and we want gold. Some say the US and its NATO allies literally couldn't afford to let that happen.
Thousands of people have gathered here on the fourth month, on the day, the anniversary, since the uprisings began in the east of Libya. They've come out here with their green flags to show defiance, to show their support for Muammar Gaddafi and his regime. And they swell to the front in great numbers to hear an audio message from brother leader.
This is the first time they are facing an armed nation of millions. They will be defeated. The alliance will be defeated.
After more than 4,000 strike sorties on Libya, NATO doesn't seem to be getting anywhere. They say it's not just about military might, it's about political will. But if you see these scenes, if you listen to the sounds and you test the will of the people here, there's really a sense that this crisis in Libya isn't ending anytime soon.